Welcome to Mysterian TV. My name is Ron Potosi. This is my wife, Teresa Potosi, and we are going to be doing Walking It Out. Please go to Mysterian TV and subscribe. Welcome to Walking It Out. Today's subject that we're going to be discussing with my wife, Teresa, is going to be love and marriage 101. That's what we're going to be discussing today. I think this is so imperative in this day and time to make sure that with all the things that are going on around us, that we are focused on our, number one, we're focused on God. Number two, we're focused on our marriage. So, well, one of the scriptures we want to read, if you would, go to 1 Corinthians 13:7. We're going to read love. As she goes to look for that scripture, I just want to make this statement. Love is a commitment. It is not a fickle feeling. It is not something that we just feel. It is something that we've made a decision, a conscious decision to love somebody. We need to understand that people say that they've fallen out of love. If they've fallen out of love, they must have just fallen into love. It's a decision that they make. Could you read that scripture, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 7?
It says, love never gives up, never loses faith. It always is always hopeful and endures through every circumstance.
Through every circumstance. Can I tell you that love is a never-ending story? There's never an end to love. It's continual. So I want you to understand that love, when you fall in love, you say you fall in love, you didn't fall, you chose to love somebody and you would continue to love them. So it's so important that we understand in marriage that it's not something that we started and now it's over with. It's continual, it's ongoing.
Right. And so there's two things that husbands and wives need. Wives need love. Husbands, they need respect.
Yes.
But it's not always easy to love somebody when they're acting unlovable. It's not always easy to show respect to somebody that isn't acting respectable. Because you want to say, well, they earn respect. They have to earn that respect. But sometimes, you know, God gives us His very best, even when we don't earn it, even when we don't, we haven't deserved it. But God gives us His best. And He expects us to be Christ-like. And so that when we're Christ-like, then we give each other our best because that is God's example to us. He always gives us our best, even His best, even when we don't deserve it, even when we haven't earned it. And it's important that in a marriage that wives respect your husbands, show them respect. Don't be downing them in front of people. Don't be questioning them in front of people. Don't be doing things that is going to show them in a bad light to make yourself look better. Show them the respect that they need and they deserve. And husbands, love your wives. The Bible says for the husband to love the wife like Christ loves the church. And when you think of how Christ loves His church, that's a tall order, guys. But that's what the husband is supposed to do. He's supposed to love his wife.
Amen. It tells us in the Word of God, in Ephesians 5:33, it says, so again, I say, each man must love his wife as he loves himself. And the wife must respect her husband. That's what the Word of God says. It's not just what my wife says. It's what the Word of God says. It said that we must respect us. So you're... Next one we want to discuss, as we're talking through things about love and marriage, is your spouse needs to, her needs, I want to point this out, her needs need to come before my needs, right? So I'm just being honest, that there's things that I do because I love her, not because I wanted to do them. And there's things that all of us, you know, their needs, their situations need to come before what our needs are. Right. So it's same thing. She looks at me and looks at the needs that are in my life. Could you read that scripture in that it's in Ephesians 5:21-25. Ephesians 5.
And it says, and further, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ.
Hold on. Submit to one another?
Yes.
We've got to learn to submit to each other.
That's right.
Right. That is so important that we're there to meet each other's needs. That's what's so important about marriage. in the way that God has set it up. Continue.
It says, wives, this means submit to your husbands as to the Lord. For a husband is the head of his wife, as Christ is the head of the church. Mm. He is the savior of his body and the church. As the church submits to Christ, so you wives should submit to your husbands in everything.
Mm.
For husbands, this means love your wives just as Christ loved the church.
Mm. Marriage, understand this, marriage means laying down your own rights. When you get married, you've laid your rights down. Because it's it's between the husband and wife now. The Bible says when you come together, you become one. So understand all these things that you like to do. Men that like to go hunting and fishing and all that stuff, that's awesome. You might still get to go. But guess what? You might have to go sit at the mall and watch as all the people go by when your wife goes shopping. I'm just being honest with you. I'm telling you the truth. Because our wants and our needs are one now. It's not just yours and mine. It's now as one.
And ladies, you might have to watch a UK game. Sorry.
Oh, come on. Amen.
You might have to even learn how to like it.
Amen.
Because so it's about giving and it's about giving and take, you know, and it's not all. He always has to do what I like to do.
Right.
You know, I have to do things that he likes to do as well. It's,
yeah.
So
even though here's the thing, and I pray that I don't lose my man card, but here's the deal is that sometimes I've got to watch Hallmark TV, right? That's, you know, and then sometimes she watches ESPN. So I just want to, rarely, but the point being is that.
Now. The only time he has to watch Hallmark is at Christmas.
Amen.
That's all.
Amen. But again, it's understanding that our needs and our wants is no longer ours. It's together. And so you're going to talk through the husband and wife being unified. Yeah.
Right. So one thing that sometimes is a obstacle is like the husband and wife always needs to be unified. They always have to be a unified front.
Come on.
Especially if you have kids.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if you have kids. You should never question your husband in front of other people, and vice versa. They shouldn't question in front of you. If you've got a disagreement, disagree privately, not in front of everybody and their brother.
Come on.
You should always be unified. It's, there's no his or hers. I don't know. I mean, this is kind of a touchy subject with people when you get into their money. But it always surprises me when I hear of married couples having their own separate bank accounts. Mm-hmm. That don't make any sense to me. Because let me tell you, ladies, everything he has is mine.
Yeah.
And what's mine is mine.
Amen.
So
just speaking truth right
we
there.
We have to be unified.
Amen.
I need access to Amen. Things.
Amen.
So, but just remember that if there's ever a question, my job as his wife is to always back him up. And his job as my husband is to always back me up. We're there for each other.
Amen. And one of the things that I can remember, I've been taught from other people is do not keep score.
No.
Right? Don't keep score. Mm-hmm. Don't keep secrets, right?
Right.
Don't, you know, we're in this thing together. You know, Genesis 2:24 reads like this. Genesis 2:24. This explains why a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united as one.
Right.
You're no longer two, you're now one. They need to be united in everything. And that is so important. Do we have different wants? Yes. But understand that we have to give. It's give and take. It's not all, hey, you're going to go fishing with me every day. That's not going to happen. So the fact of the matter is all of us have to realize what the way that we are focused and we need to understand, you know, next we need to understand that can I tell you, marriage doesn't just take two. Can I tell you, marriage takes three? It takes God, the husband, and the wife. Mm-hmm.
If you don't, order.
In that order, God, the husband and the wife, in that order. If you don't have God, number one, in your relationship is going to struggle. Can I tell you that once you get out of divine alignment, then all Hades breaks loose, not just in your relationship, but all around you, in your family, all those things. Husband, we understand this, God, husband, wife. Grow in relationship with God together. Can I tell you that you need to pray together?
Amen. It's important.
We need to pray together. Not just, okay, we're going to go pray with the ladies. They're going to pray with the ladies. Men going to pray with the We need to pray together. In a marriage, those that pray together, stay together. Come on. The more you love God, the more you'll love each other. The closer you draw to God, the more you will love each other. You got Deuteronomy 31 and 8. But you've got to work at it. Can I tell you that it doesn't happen without trying? Anything that's worth anything takes work. So you have to work at being there. Number one, work at spending time with God in prayer. Work at spending time with your wife and praying with her and spending time with her. And as the wife, to spend time with the husband. Right. It takes work. Deuteronomy 31:8.
Let me say this, is that it's important to pray for your spouse. Because I'm going to tell you, we've been married for 25 years, and here in just a few months we'll be married 25 years. Do you know that I don't always know what he's thinking? I don't always know what he's feeling. I don't always know what he's going through. But God does. And so when I pray for him, God gives me downloads, and he lets me know what's going on with him and how I can handle that and how to better deal with that situation, and vice versa when he prays for me. God will minister to you, and he will minister into your marriage. And I'm going to tell you something. There's not a counselor on earth that is better than the God that we serve at counseling you in prayer.
Amen.
When you're in prayer and you're praying, you cannot stay mad at your spouse if you are praying for them and you're lifting them up before God with a sincere heart. You can't stay mad. You can't stay offended.
Yeah.
And offense will come.
Yeah.
The Word of God says that.
Yeah.
But when you pray for them, offense has to go.
Amen. Amen. The Word says, don't let the sun go down on your wrath. My wife says it like this, never go to bed angry, stay up all night and fight it out. So, can I tell you, marriage is as is. There's no returns. Marriage is as is. You've got to work at it.
No exchanges.
No exchanges. You've got to work at it. You've got to continually push. You got to continually focus on your marriage, just like you have to focus on your relationship with the Lord. You've got to set aside time, because if you do not set aside time, somebody will set aside time.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
Well, I'm just going to go old school just a little bit here. Just a little bit.
Right.
And it is from my generation, but it's still good advice. Ladies, don't always walk around in your house in your pajamas. Fix yourself up for your honey. He's still you still need to date him. You still need to look nice for him. You still need to flirt with him. Make him feel good about himself. Make yourself look nice. You know, this, I don't understand these young ladies nowadays that just go around, you know, and say, oh, well, he knows how I am. He knows what I look like. He can deal with it.
Yeah.
No, because just like he said, if you don't spend time with them, somebody will. Well, honey, if you don't take the time to flirt with your husband or your wife, if you don't take time to date them and to make them feel special, somebody will.
Amen. So I would put this number one on our list, but we put this last on our list today. So well, I want to talk through this. So 1 Corinthians, you want to read it, hon? 1 Corinthians chapter 7, 3 through 4. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, 3 through 4. 3 and 4. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, 3 and 4.
Okay. The husband should fulfill his wife's needs, and the wife should fulfill her husband's needs. Mm-hmm. The wife gives authority over her body to her husband, and the husband gives authority over his body to his wife. It says, do not deprive each other of their needs.
Exactly.
Unless you both agree to refrain from their needs for a limited time.
Amen. So it's important. People, again, we're not going to go into detail, so don't be afraid of that. Understand that the husband needs to meet the woman's needs, and the woman and the wife
That's
needs
right.
to meet the man's needs. That this is something that we need to understand in marriage. Mm-hmm. So everything that we have going on, and the power, that's why it's so important. Can I share this right now? That is why it's so important that you don't go and have sex outside of wedlock, because there is power when you get mm-hmm. married. There is power, and it's not just a physical thing. It's a spiritual thing as well. And so it's so important that we understand in this day and hour that the marriage, the sanctity of marriage, is so important. Mm-hmm. That we need to understand that everything that we are doing, everything, even spending time when we wake up in the morning, I think it's so important that when we get up in the morning, that we spend time with the Lord in prayer. Amen. Get into the Word, but we also need to spend time letting our wife or our husband know how much we love them, right? Now, my wife sometimes gets a little upset with me just being transparent, because I want to kiss her when I get up early in the morning. She says, don't kiss me, I'm sleeping. Hello? But so I want to meet her need. Her needs are not to be kissed when she's asleep. So we've got to learn how to take care of one another. We got to be there for one another. So what's important about marriage is looking at the other person's needs and meeting those needs, caring for them, being there right there for them. I am so thankful that I have this beautiful, anointed wife that understands what God says about marriage, that understands what God says about how to be a not even a good, but a great wife. And I just want to be the best husband that I can be to her. I am so thankful. Please make sure that...
He does a pretty good job.
I do a pretty good job. Thank you. Thank
you. He's awesome.
So, you need to make sure that we are focusing on the good, right?
Right, absolutely.
Can I tell you this? And this isn't just with marriage. This is with life in general. Let's focus on the good.
Amen.
I mean, I could go through a list of things, and she definitely could go through a list of things on me that is not good. But let's focus on the things that are good.
Positive.
Let's focus on the things that are good and pure, and focus on those things. And I want to tell you that your marriage, if you will just follow these couple little guidelines we talked through in Scripture, your marriage will be stronger than ever before. Have a blessed day. And please, please, please come back and check out Walking It Out. In Jesus' name, amen.